It is my firm belief, Director Cheatle, that you should resign. However, in complete defiance, Director Cheatle has maintained she will not tender her resignation. Therefore, she will answer questions today from members of this committee seeking to provide clarity to the American people about how these events were allowed to transpire. We will ask these questions because the Secret Service and its parent agency, the Department of Homeland Security, have been unwilling to provide answers to the American people. DHS has sought to push this hearing to a different time. Secret Service has suggested the hearing occur without media presence, and both agencies have provided only shallow explanations to Congress about what happened on July 13th. Indeed, DHS and Secret Service's lack of communication with the Oversight Committee required me to issue a subpoena compelling Director Cheatle to attend today, and still DHS requested more time to prepare. It shouldn't take this much time or preparation, Director Cheatle, to tell the truth and to be transparent with the American people. I am thankful to the ranking member, Mr. Raskin, for joining me in insisting that Director Cheatle appear today. God knows the ranking member and I disagree on many things, but that does not matter today. The safety of Secret Service protectees is not based on their political affiliation, and the bottom line is that under Director Cheadle's leadership, we question whether anyone is safe. Not President Biden, not the First Lady, not the White House, and certainly not the presidential candidates. The July 13th assassination attempt is one of the darkest days in American political history. It represents the ugliest parts of what American politics has become: hatred of each other and a dangerous turn to extremism. Before we are Republicans or Democrats, we are Americans. If we place our political affiliations above our duty and love of country, we cannot maintain a country. We must ensure our republic is strong, and our republic cannot be strong when our leadership, our elections, our institutions, and our candidates are threatened by extremism and violence. Today, Director Cheatle will answer questions about why she deserves to continue to play a critical role in preserving this country's safety and, at the very least, what led to the catastrophic, deadly events on July 13th in Butler, Pennsylvania. Again, I do not believe Director Cheatle deserves to maintain her position as head of the Secret Service, but members of the American people will make their own decisions based on her answers today. I urge Director Cheatle to be transparent and forthcoming in her testimony today. Americans deserve no less. We have a duty to find out how this happened and to ensure it never happens again. I now yield to Ranking Member Raskin for his opening statement.
Thank you kindly, Chairman Comer.